In last lecture, we have studied the how to remember the trigonometric formulas. Today, in this lecture, we will see the about the set theory and functions, because this is very important. In there is one subject for you. The name of that subject is the probability and statistics. For this probability statistics, the set theory is very, very important. So, what is the meaning of set? Set is well defined distinct object. So see, this is very important. Well defined. What is the meaning of well defined? Suppose you are taking the sets of pen. You can in that set you can take any different pen. Means what? Distinct means what? You can take any different pens, as like red pen, blue pen, black pen. But that atom or that elements of that set must be pen. If you are defining the sets of the pen, and if you are included that in that set, there is one refill, then that is not a well defined. Are you getting the meaning of well defined? Well defined means what? If you are taking the sets of pens, and if you are included in that set, there is other refill, then that is not a well defined. And in that set, atoms or elements of or numbers of that set must be a distinct. Means what? In the set, for example, see here. So set of the number. Generally, set is denoted by capital letters, as like A, B, C, X, Y, Z. And its symbol is as like see here. So this is a set of numbers 1, 2, 3, 4 or 5. This is a finite set. Why it is finite? We will see what is the meaning of finite in next. Finite means what? Set contain numbers. So this is a symbol of the set. And in set, set cannot be written in that way. 1, 1, 2, 3, 3. So this is a wrong. Why? In set, one number is not repeat once again. Repeat means what's here? There are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is a well-defined and correct definition of that set. This is a not a set. Why? There is one number which repeats two times. So this is not a well-defined. So set, describing, there are two methods. First method is the roster method. Roster method, and second method is the set builder method. Set builder method. Firstly, we will see the about roster method. In this method, set is described by listing all its elements separating them by curly bracket. Means here, suppose example is that A is a set. This set is the set of odd numbers. Means for see here 1, 3, 5, 7 plus so on. So this is the method which describe the roster methods. Means what? Any two elements, म्हणजे हे जे एलिमेंट्स आहेत ह्या एलिमेंट मध्ये जर कॉमनस इंडिकेट्स करत असेल तर त्या मेथडला म्हणायचं असतं रोस्टर मेथड. आणि आफ्टर दॅट वील सी द नेक्स्ट मेथड, दॅट इज द सेट बिल्डर मेथड. हाऊ टू डिस्क्राइब दिस सेट बिल्डर मेथड वील सी हियर. सेकंड टाईप टू डिस्क्राइबिंग द सेट मीन्स सेट आपण दोन प्रकारे दर्शवू शकतो. सेकंड पार्ट जो आहे सेट बिल्डर मेथड. सो सेट बिल्डर मेथड इज द डिस्क्राइब्ड बाय सम प्रॉपर्टी. अ सेट इज described by some properties. See here, for example, we see an example. Set of prime number less than 10. This can be written in the form of set. Set of all x such that x is prime number and less than 10. This is less than 10. So A is a set that containing, so x is any unknown, this symbol is called as a such that. Set up all a, this how you do this, set up all x such that x is the prime number and less than 10. So which are the prime numbers? Take prime number which is less than 10, that is 2, 3, 5, 7. 9 is not number, 10 is also not number. So this is the set builder method and this is the roster method, both methods. But elements of that numbers are the same, but description of these both sets are the different. So after description of this set, we will see the different types of set. First is the finite set. Finite set. What is the meaning of finite set? In that word, there is a meaning, that is a set containing finite number is called as finite set. For example, set of alphabets. So we know that how many alphabets? Only 26. Means what? It is a countable. A set containing finite numbers is called as a finite set. This is the type, first types of the set. Second type, infinite set. What is the meaning of infinite set? A set containing infinite number of elements is called as infinite set. For example, you can take set of real numbers. We know that this is a real line. Here 0, here 1, 2, up to the plus infinity. Here minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, here infinite, minus infinity. So there is a so many plus finite number, infinite number, has some infinite numbers. There are so many set which are the infinite set. That is a set of real number. This is called as R, set of real number, set of rational numbers, set of integers. These all are the infinite sets. After that, we will see next set, that is null set. Third type. Null set, or this is called as a zero set. A set containing empty set, empty number, is called as null set. Or a set having no element is called as null set, or other name is a void set. For example, see here, set of all x, x is an integer and x square is equal to 2. What is the meaning of this? So A is any set here. Take any set, any number which is integer and its square is equal to 2. Which type of this number? Asa kutla number ahe jo number integers ahe and tyacha square kelyanantar 2 yeto. Tar integers kutle kutle aste? 1 0 प्लस वन माइनस वन प्लस टू माइनस टू प्लस थ्री माइनस थ्री. जीरो चा स्क्वेअर आता बघा, जीरो हा इंटीजर आहे, त्याचा स्क्वेअर करा जीरो येईल. वनचा स्क्वेअर करा वन येईल. मायनस वनचा स्क्वेअर करा वन येईल. टूचा स्क्वेअर करा फोर येईल. पण असा कुठला नंबर आहे का ज्याचा स्क्वेअर केल्यानंतर, बघा दोन देर आर टू कंडिशन. फर्स्ट इज द दॅट नंबर मस्ट बी इंटीजर अँड इट्स अ स्क्वेअर इज टू. तर आपला दोन कंडिशन त्या ठिकाणी, त्याचा तो नंबर इंटीजर्स पाहिजे आणि त्याचा स्क्वेअर किती पाहिजे? टू. तसा कुठलाच नंबर नाही, कारण काय, इंटीजर्स कुठले कुठले आहे? झिरो, प्लस मायनस वन, प्लस मायनस टू. झिरोचा स्क्वेअर करा झिरो, वनचा स्क्वेअर करा वन, टूचा स्क्वेअर करा फोर, त्याचा स्क्वेअर करा नाईन. पण असा कुठलाच नंबर नाही ज्यांचा स्क्वेअर टू येतो, म्हणजेच हा कुठला सेट झाला, त्याच्यामध्ये काहीच नाही, म्हणजे झिरोसुद्धा नंबर नाही, म्हणजे हा सेट काय झाला, ज्यामध्ये एकही नंबर नाही, तो झिरो सेट झाला. दॅट टाईप ऑफ सेट इज कॉल्ड ॲज द नल सेट ऑर व्हाईट सेट. नेक्स्ट फोर्थ नंबर, सिंगल टर्न सेट. अ सेट हॅविंग ओनली वन एलिमेंट is called as singleton set. Is called as singleton set. For example, you can take any number A, second number 1, or any number 2. So these are all examples of the singleton set. After that, we'll see the fifth number, subset or and superset. Subset and superset. Suppose if A and B are two sets such that every elements of A elements of A is also elements of B, then A is called as called a subset of B. For example, see here, A. Suppose A is 1, 2, 3 and B is the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Set A is 1, 2, 3 and set B is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, every elements of B, what is the order of elements of B? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. B contain 5 elements. A contain 3 elements. So, every element of B contains in A. Hence, A is a subset of B. And B is the superset of A. So, there are some element in B which are not included in A. So, because of that, B is a superset of the element A and A is the subset of element B. This is the symbol of subset, A subset of B. This also can be written as B is the superset of A. B is the superset of A. This is a symbol of superset. This is a symbol of subset. These all symbols are very important in the subject probability and statistics. After that, we'll see the next set, that is equality of sets. Equality of sets. Two sets A and B are said to be equal if and only if, this is called as if and only if, they contain same elements. Suppose, for example, one thing is remaining. So subset in Venn diagram, this can be written as in that way. So this is a B, suppose this is the A. So A is belongs to in this B, hence A is subset of B and B is superset of A. This is in the form of Venn diagram. This equality of set. Equality of set means what? A, B are two sets contain same element. For example, A contains element 1, 2, 3 and B contains alphabets A, B, C. So, number of elements in A is 3 and numbers of elements in B is also 3. So, that both A and B are the said to be an equal set. Means there is no need to the for equality of set that both numbers are the same numbers. Means what? तर ह्या दोन्ही सेट मध्ये आपल्याला नंबर सेम असावा याचा मीनिंग की बाबा इथं पण 1 2 आहेत म्हणजे इथं पण 1 2 राहावा असं नाही. तर ह्या ठिकाणी जेवढं काउंट आहे तो पण ह्या ठिकाणी काउंट असेल. त्या दोन्ही सेटला म्हणायचं असते इक्वालिटी ऑफ सेट. आफ्टर दॅट वी विल सी द कंपेरेबल सेट. Comparable sets. If two sets A and B are such that either A is subset of B or B is subset of A, then A and B are said to be comparable sets. For example, see here, A contains 1, 3, 5. B set is the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then here A is subset of B. Then we can call this as A is comparable with B. Next example. Suppose A contains 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. B contains 2, 4. So, in this case, this B is subset of A. So, in this case, this is also A and B are the comparable set. After that, we will see the operations on the set. Operations on the set. So, which are the operations? First is the union. Second is intersection. So, we'll see the first about the union. What is the meaning of union? So, this is a union and intersection is a very, very important concept which will be required for our next semester. The union of two sets A and B is the set of all elements which belongs to either A or B. So we'll see the by Venn diagram. Suppose this is A set, this is the B set. Means what? Elements which belongs to in either A or B. Or both. Here, for example, A contains 1, 2, 3, 4. B contains 3, 4, 5, 6. So, operation A union B. So, this is a symbol. A union B. A union B is the 1. Take the elements of in containing A. 1, 2, 3, 4. After that, A or B. So, 3 element already repeated. So, don't repeat again once time. So, what about 4? 4 is also here. So, don't take again repeat. So, what about 5? 5 is not here. 6. So, this is a operation A union B. Means what? Elements containing in A, containing in B and in both. So, this is called as A union B. After that, we will see about the intersection. Second operation, intersection. Suppose A and B are set which contain which contains common element in A and B. For example, see here, A contains 1, 2, 3, 4. B contain 3, 4, 5, 6. Then what is the A intersection B? Elements which is common in A and B. This is very important. In previous union, A or B, here A and B. Means what? Which are the elements in A as well as in B? So that is 3 number is repeated in A as well as B. What about 4? 4 numbers are repeated in A as well as B. So this is A intersection B. This is a symbol. So we will see the Venn using the Venn diagram. So this is the elements which is common in A and common in B. So this is A intersection B. So in next lecture, we will see about the functions, relations and its example. So this is a complete description about the set theory.